What we're looking at here is the Microsoft Surface Laptop 7th edition. This is nothing new. It's been out for about a year or so now, but I just acquired it not too long ago. And this is my review. So I purchased this laptop from Costco for $1,099. And this was a few months ago. I don't know if the price has gone up because of the tariffs or not, but this model that I purchased comes with the Snapdragon X Plus 10 core processor, 16 gigs of RAM, a 1 terabyte SSD drive, a 1080p camera with a facial recognition that works really well, Wi-Fi 7, and a 13.8 inch HDR touchscreen. So overall, the laptop feels really good. It has this aluminum body, comfortable keyboard, feels overall pretty solid and premium. The Snapdragon processor that this comes with puts this kind of into MacBook Air territory. It competes a little bit with the M chips. Is it as good? Maybe, maybe not. But you know, if you're a Windows user, it doesn't really matter. And we're gonna take a look and see how this machine performs in different areas. The Snapdragon CPU requires a special version of Windows 11, Windows 11 ARM. And to get the best performance, the applications you use should be Windows ARM compatible. This will ensure that the software makes the best use of the processor, and if an application isn't Windows ARM compatible, it might still run in an emulation mode and offer slightly slower performance, or it might not work at all. These machines have been out a year, so most of the software issues have been worked out. Users who mostly stick to web browsing, YouTube, office productivity softwares, they'll be happy with this laptop's performance. Apps like Microsoft Office, LibreOffice, Edge and Chrome web browsers, and countless other applications are now ARM compatible and run noticeably fast on this laptop. Most of the software issues have been worked out. There are certain softwares that won't work, but we'll get to that later. I'm not a professional video editor. I typically use free software like Clipchamp, Shotcut, yes, I'm one of those people, Kden Live, and I've occasionally dabbled with DaVinci Resolve, only to remember what a resource hog it is, and that most of its features I don't even use. But I figured DaVinci Resolve would be a good benchmark of how this laptop performs under stress. And it seems to do pretty well, at least with my 1080p HD footage. Without using proxy clips, timeline playback was smooth and trimming was a breeze. And I'll remind you, this laptop only has 16 gigs of RAM plus the Snapdragon processor. I think that combination works really well. Plus, DaVinci Resolve, the free version, is built for Windows ARM. All of those factors make for a very decent video editing experience. The trackpad. So this trackpad is the best I've ever used on a Windows machine. Previous laptops, I never really bothered with the trackpad too much because they just never worked well. They all kind of sucked, but this one is actually good. You can see it's very responsive. I can do my scrolling. If I'm doing it correctly, I can pinch to zoom. There we go. All in all, it works quite well. I'm very happy with the trackpad. I don't mind bringing this to the couch and using it without a mouse when the trackpad is this nice. Kudos to Microsoft for making this trackpad a pleasure to use. I recommend visiting the Surface Touch Use and Settings Microsoft link that I'll provide in the description, and it'll get you familiar with all the trackpad gestures. The touchscreen. I don't know if I mentioned that this has a touchscreen. I, to be honest, don't use this feature. I don't see why I would with such a good trackpad. The screen would just get smudges on it. I'm not a big touchscreen person. Needless to say, I have nothing to report on the touchscreen performance. I don't play video games. I am not a gamer, so I can't really attest to how this machine works for playing games. I'm sure it's fine. It's not really a gaming laptop. The only thing I do is play a little bit of solitaire, and it works fine for that. My guess is if you're buying this laptop, you are not looking to do any serious gaming. So one frustration I have with this laptop is my Canon inkjet printer is not compatible with it. Canon has had over a year to update their software and drivers for Windows 11 ARM, but they haven't done so. Now, the scanning functionality does work, but I cannot print to my printer. So let this be a warning to you. If you're considering this laptop, make sure the applications and the external devices you use with it are either ARM compatible or at least work through emulation. Check out the Windows ARM software compatibility list that I will provide in the description below to make sure that your software is compatible with this machine. So overall, I'm impressed with the Microsoft Surface 7 laptop. The build quality and performance are great, and it does what I need it to. Minus the printing to my Canon printer, of course. While its battery life doesn't live up to the 20 hours promised by Microsoft, it can make an entire workday and then some on one battery charge when doing routine browsing and office suite tasks. I tried going a day of typical use on battery alone, and after about 12 hours, had about 27% of battery life remaining, which I consider pretty darn good. Certainly better than any other Windows laptop I've ever had. So how does this compare to the M4 MacBook Air? Maybe I'll address that in a future video. But if you're a Windows user, I think you're gonna like the experience here. Just make sure that your software is compatible with it. So if you're in the market for a quality Windows laptop, I think this one is worth checking out.